Now we come to table number two, and we welcome the game's number one ambassador, a sporting legend, the most successful individual sportsman England has ever produced, over 70 major titles are locked away in his cabinet of dreams. Ladies and gentlemen, the incomparable six times Embassy World Champion, Steve Davis. Young, cool, classy, and extremely talented. A terrific advertisement to the up-and-coming young stars of the future. Will you welcome, please, the world number one, the young Wizard of Ushaw, a former Embassy World Champion, John Higgins.
Well, John Higgins and Steve Davis about to begin the first of their three sessions of play. It's the best of 25 frames in this second round. And this is the opening frame, which will be described for you by Dennis Taylor and Clive Everton.
One of the great champions of the 90s takes on the greatest champion of the 80s.
Thank you very much. First frame, John Higgins to break.
Couldn't have got much closer with his initial attempt at a long red. Davis says that he's extremely happy with the way that he's queuing. And John Higgins demonstrated how well he was queuing and coming through a very tough first round match against Dave Harold, 10-8. I've not seen Dave Harold play much better than he did against the 1998 champion.
First blood in this match goes to Steve Davis. And Steve is well aware that when he gets this type of chance, he won't be able to miss too many easy opportunities with the class of the opponent that he's up against. Referee Barry White having to find the nearest spot behind the pink spot that's available. All the other spots are still occupied. So in a direct line with the black spot without touching that red.
Seven.
Steve there just carrying on with this new little idea of his of eyeing the shot up before he gets down. Let's see if he does it again here.
Fifteen.
There we go. It certainly worked for him in his opening match.
He stoops to conquer, or hopes to conquer. His theory is that it helps him to identify the precise contact point he needs to make on the object ball.
24.
Yes, I can't see it making a lot of difference, but psychologically it seems to be working for Steve. He's done everything in the game. He's one of these players that has worked on his grip with his backhand. He's changed little things. He's always looking for something different. Now, cannon into the pack is not really on here, so into the red, the left side of the red, and then the pack maybe here. Not quite as he intended,
31.
But he wanted a thicker contact on that red that's just gone towards the side cushion. And this is the type of shot that he's got to be knocking in against John Higgins.
But didn't intend to cannon the black.
Yellow ball. Steve Davis, 32.
A nice young man, John Higgins. He was smiling as he was playing that shot because there was a mobile phone going off somewhere in the building. It obviously shows that his concentration is there, Clive, to pot that with the telephone sound and his little smile as well.
John Higgins, what?
The black was too far away and too straight. Some people would say that Steve Davis has achieved so much. Why does he need to play on when he's not quite the player he was? But the answer is that there's nothing like it. Nothing like the visceral excitement of a big match. 7. And you've played quite a few big matches against him, Dennis. Not just the great world final, which you won 18-17, but many matches over the years here.
Yes, in fact, I didn't realize how many frames I'd played against this man at the Crucible Theatre in the Embassy World Championship. And John D in the press room just reminded me I've played him 128 frames here. So I've had a few battles against him, and every one of them thoroughly enjoyable. First mistake from Steve, and don't be surprised if John Higgins doesn't try to clip this in and split the reds and pink. He might just be tempted to do that. He's 31 behind.
Whoa.
He's very unlucky though, and now he's in real trouble here. White could have finished anywhere, but I think he might be better playing the black here, because I can't see how he can get to any other color. And if he was to land on the black, it would be reasonably safe. So, nice little nestle onto the black.
Foul and a miss. John Higgins, one. Steve Davis, seven.
Perhaps hit it a little hard. Wanted to hit it just to reach the black. He was certainly right to attempt it off two cushions, because if he attempted to hit the black direct, there's probable enough.
Under miss, Steve Davis, seven.
Well, that was a long way out. And Davis won't be having the cue ball replaced this time.
Yes, the reason he will take this red on, he's got a bit of angle, so he can get the white away from the cushion and leave the black on.
One.
Still has a red to middle.
Yes, he'll have to play for green or brown, I think, here. Blue's not available to the left centre pocket.
Nine.
He's just a little bit short of pace. He's got a long way to go now with the cue ball when taking the brown. Wanted to be another 12 inches up the table with the cue ball. So a lot of topspin on this to get back up the table. Well, in fact, he's going to screw back, as you can see. Applying bottom to the white. Where's the brown? No,
Steve Davis, nine.
Well, where is the brown? He's been very, very lucky there. He'd left quite a few on. Missed the brown by a long way, but eventually the brown has knocked a red safe.
Thank you.
tried to leave Davis bridging over the top of the yellow.
Might just be enough room for John to take that red on to the right of the four reds and brown. It looks as if it'll pass the brown up into the corner pocket. You could play for the pink or black and leave things relatively safe if it doesn't go in, but if this goes in, it could give him a good chance. One. Although he's 52 points behind, good chance to make inroads to that lead.
Higgins could certainly make Davis regret losing position when he was 53 in front. Had to play a deep screw from Brown to try to regain it and miss the pot.
Nine.
And the ball's promisingly placed for a winning clearance.
I was really impressed with John Higgins in his match with Dave Harold.
31.
Mentioned Dave Harold played some fantastic snooker, but this young Scot responded with a 141 break and then another century towards the final stages of that match.
32.
He just knows his way around the table so well. Perfect angle on the pink to leave that last red for the same pocket. And looking at the balls, it should be straightforward, but we all know what can happen at the Crucible.
38.
He'll need up to and including the pink.
45. Forty-nine. 53.
So far, so immaculate. He only needs the pink.
64. And great.
Steve Davis held a 53-point lead. That is John Higgins with 64 to the pink, who takes the opening frame. John Higgins in fine fettle then, as he has been in winning three titles this season, the only player on the circuit to do so. The Grand Prix at Preston, when he beat Mark Williams 9-8 in the final. The Welsh Open in Cardiff, when he beat Stephen Lee 9-8 in the final. And the Irish Masters, when he beat Stephen Hendry 9-4 for that title. He's had one or two unexpected losses when he seems to have arrived at tournaments not really focused. Lost to a couple of players who he would normally be expected to beat. Peter Lines in China and Billy Snadden, his fellow Scot, in Thailand. But he looks highly focused at the Crucible, doesn't he, Dennis?
Well, yes, that was a terrific opening frame to win, because Steve Davis looked favourite all the way until he missed that brown. And it'll be interesting to see how Steve copes with that loss in the opening frame, because he should really have won it.
Frame two, Steve Davis to break.
Not only a great pot, but knew that the cannon on the second ball would be at such an angle that the cue ball would still come back towards the balk line.
John Higgins, one.
Davis is usually very strong with his tactical play, but he's left it a long way short this time, and the pot, there's no value in taking the pot to the left because of the positional side of it. You see, John Higgins is going to be able to compete with Steve in the safety exchanges. Very good tactical player himself. The difference in this match may be that John may take advantage of the mistakes a little bit more than Steve might. It's all fascinating to see how it's going to turn out. As I say, if Steve hadn't missed the brown in the opening frame, he would have been one more in the lead.
No. John.
Davis knew that he wasn't playing for position on the colour there. It's fine that the red has gone in. But if it hadn't, he was hoping it was going to wriggle clear and leave nothing for his opponent. He knew, the way he played it, that if
Steve
it went
Davis,
in,
what?
He would only have a safety shot next.
John Higgins can see enough of the red to the right of the bunch, and it may possibly be a plant. Play it as a shot to nothing. I'm not sure if the two reds are in line for the pocket. We'll find out very shortly.
Still a good safety though. A return to Bourque off the red, next but one to the pink. He's taking the cue ball dangerously near the corner pocket. The back red is tight on the cushion, which makes a safety very difficult from that one.
Yes, I think he's got to come down off the left of the reds. Needs a very thin contact, but that's the easiest one to get back down the table off. Now, if he takes the one that's to the left of the pink, he would go close to the in off. There's a little bit more risk with this one. Cleverly played.
Yes, played with right of centre striking. That swung the cue ball wide of the pocket and checked back off the second cushion, avoiding any other ball and getting back to Bourque. Well-devised shot and certainly debatable whether Higgins can cut the red into the right middle.
Very fortunate here is John. Very fortunate. And I think Steve's going to have to come twice across the table and try and land on the red that's near the left corner pocket. If he can judge it correctly, somewhere near the white line will get him to that red. He's got to be very precise though.
Foul and a miss. John Higgins, four. One.
So, Higgins is lucky snooker. Has created a good opening.
Eight. Nine.
A And then taking this next red, he's clearing the path for another red into the 16. Opposite corner pocket. And these are all shots that the players are thinking about. So people ask you how many shots you're thinking ahead. It's really only two or three, but you're leaving yourself options all the time.
17.
I don't know whether he can get to the striking point of the middle of the white. No, it's a little bit awkward, but not a lot to do with the cue ball. And that's always a possibility,
Higgins,
striking
17.
Over the red. Possibly just got a little touch of side onto the cue ball, and it just sent the pink slightly offline.
One. Six. Seven.
Doesn't really want to be potting the pink because of the two reds that's near the pink spot, so he's got the perfect angle on the blue to play for either of those.
Twelve.
These are the sort of opportunities which Davis has got to exploit. He doesn't pot quite the percentage of long balls that he used to, but if his opponent misses when he's in and leaves him in at short range, then he needs to make the most of it.
13.
The fact that he developed a few more reds now means that he can take the pink. He won't be able to pot the one just to the left of the pink spot, but the other two are available, and also the one to the left of the black, so it's developed into a good chance.
19. Twenty-seven. Twenty-eight. Thirty-five. Thirty-six.
Davis making sure that he picks off the easy reds first. He's going to need one of the two near the left-hand corner. In addition, if he's to clinch the frame at this visit.
43.
He's just working out how he's going to get to those two reds. If he pots the pink and the red to the right, he really wants to get the white over to the left side of the table to be able to pot the black and cannon those two reds. He can't really do that from the other side. He's a little bit straighter. That's not exactly where he wanted the cue ball. So it may have to be a change of plan, because if he just pots that, stares this side of the black, he'd have to be absolutely spot on the black to give himself a chance to move the two reds. There'll be a change of plan possibly here. And
51.
He might have a slight angle on the pink. I think he was playing up for the blue to leave himself an angle to cannon the reds. If he's just off straight, and he is, he can follow this through. The white will come off the left side cushion and might just cannon that red out of the way. He's 30 in front. Pink will put him 36. So he just needs one of those two reds. It's much more difficult off the blue. He's got a long way to travel to get up to move the reds. Well, that's a typical Steve Davis shot.
51.
But it means that John Higgins can still win.
I think Davis intended to put the blue safer than he has, because that must have been one of the ideas in playing the blue.
Well, I really did think he had an angle on the pink to pot it and bring the reds into play, but as you said, Clive, with leaving the blue on, it although he's 30 points in front, it's still anyone's frame.
Yes, going back to that shot choice, I don't think Davis trusts his pure potting quite as much as he used to. More inclined to take the tactical approach, even the grinding approach.
Do you know, there's one little shot on here that Steve could play. He could double kiss that red and take the white up behind the blue. It was another option open to him there.
Quite a well thought out shot he has played, because he's left the cue ball so close to the one red that Higgins can't do anything with it, and he's got to bridge over it to play any sort of shot at the other one. Good shot from Higgins, though. Always a chance of a mistake if you leave your opponent playing from tight on the ball cushion. attempted the red there, knowing that if he didn't pot it, the cue ball was coming back behind the balk line.
Another half chance for Steve. And I think he can avoid the cannon onto the black. Player, this is a shot to nothing, but if it goes in, it might just clinch him this second frame.
One.
31 the difference. He's going to need that last red to secure the frame, but when he starts knocking this type of pot in, be a very tough opponent to beat. The green's the shot that'll get him up to the red. You can take the green on and just let the white slide up past pink and black, and that would virtually secure the frame. I think he's got to play that shot. The angle's there just to avoid the cannon on the pink when potting the green.
No positional heroics required here.
Five.
Because the red alone left Higgins needing two snookers to tie, even if Davis doesn't pot this black.
No ball.
Chooses the blue instead. So we can safely say
10
that the maestro has levelled the match at 1-1.
Steve Davis, 10. Frame conceded, frame Steve Davis.
A 51 break by Davis. Put him in the lead, he consolidated and levelled at 1-1.
Well, 1-1 after the first two frames. Let's get Willie Thorne's thoughts on what you've seen so far, Willie. Anything significant that you've spotted?
Definitely a fair result, the first two frames. John Higgins did remarkably well to win the first frame after being down and out, really, 60-odd points behind. That frame, Davis just knuckled in, and the break he had there, Dennis mentioned he should have took the pink. I thought he should have took the pink. In the end, it could have cost him the frame, the fact that he didn't really put Higgins under any pressure, but got away with it and then potted a good long red to go on to win the frame. So all in all, about fair.
Yeah, and that's what we wanted, both players finding a bit of form early on. And we're hoping this will be a close match, because a lot of people are saying, no, John should win this one with a bit to spare.
Well, tactically, see, Davis can compete with Higgins, but I don't think he should really get involved in too much tactics, because, you know, Higgins can compete with him. When he played against Graham Dott, you know, OK, it affected Graham Dott, it got him at it. He's not going to get John Higgins at it by playing slow and playing good tactics. Mm. But quite clearly, he looks to be queuing quite nicely, which is good, which gives him a bit of confidence going into this match.
Yeah. John, of course, had that very tough opening match against Dave Harrell. Mm. Dave played awfully well. Maybe should have been 9-8 in front, but John came back to the last three frames. Not a bad thing to have had such a tough opener, is it?
I think that'll be great, because Dave Howard really is a really tough workmanlike player and a very, very hard man to beat. Davis is very similar. Steve Davis doesn't quite score as good as Dave Howard does these days, but he's still quite capable in the safety department. I think that, as you rightly say, will stand in him terrific stead for the rest of the tournament.
Yeah, well, we've all talked many times about what it is about John Higgins that impresses everyone, but his temperament is right up there as one of his major attributes, really, isn't it?
I would have to suggest that John Higgins is the second Steve Davis as far as temperament's concerned, because nothing seems to ruffle him. Obviously, now and again, he twitches a little bit like all top players do. Even you see the Hendrys of this world, you know, sometimes missing under pressure. Mm. John Higgins is no different to anybody else. But what John Higgins does do, he never refuses to play the right shot, which is the reason he's got up there in the top two players in the world, and obviously last year number one as well.
Yeah, They've both taken a break after that second frame. Steve takes a few breaks these days, and Graham Dott got a bit upset about
every
that.
Every frame, according to Graham Dott, I think, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they're not always going out to the loo, no. Are they? I mean, a lot of the time they're just going out to take a few deep breaths and clear your head, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's just that little walk, you know, in backstage, cool down, because it's very hot out there sometimes. Backstage is a little bit cooler. Just gather your thoughts. Just all of a sudden decide whether you're thinking you're playing too attacking or too negative. But they've both come back off their break now, and both suitably refreshed, and third frame we're looking forward to.
We certainly are. Let's rejoin Clive and Dennis.
Unlike tennis, no rules for toilet breaks yet. Maybe there will be in a year or two in snooker.
I suppose, Clive, when you go back years ago, neither player used to ever leave the arena. I think it was maybe Terry Griffiths might have been the first to introduce that, and Terry had a bit of a weak bladder, so that was the reason he used to disappear every frame. And of course we used to have the big Canadian Bill Werbenick, a great character. He used to go out quite a bit, but I suppose that was something to do with the amount of lager that he used to consume.
A pint per frame.
Changed days in the snooker world. All these young men are slim and a lot fitter than we used to be.
Higgins turning down the red behind the black because the cue ball would be bound to cannon the black and he couldn't control it.
Foul. Ooh. Steve Davis, four.
That surprised him. I think the reason was that the first red was set firmly against another, so it was like going into the weight of two balls. Foul. So that threw it very wide.
Well, it could turn out to be quite a good shot because it's left Steve with a very difficult long pot. There's two possible reds he could take, the one closest to the blue to the right corner. There's one to the left corner, but I don't think Steve really wants to be having a go here. He may just play a straightforward safety shot back down the table.
Made sure he was getting the cue ball over the awkward, congested side, even without cannoning the brown.
Well, I think this is the difference in both players. John Higgins, well, now he's spotted one that he may be able to play as a shot to nothing, take the pot on and get back down the table. He got half of it right.
I don't see a way back for Davis here.
Yes, he may play one of those, well, this is an attacking Steve Davis. Lots of bottom on the cue ball that could go everywhere here. No, that's not going to, he'll have a quick look at his tip just to make sure he hasn't taken a little piece out of it. He's checked the cloth first of all, but he may have gotten away with everything here. No foul shot because he didn't jump the ball. It was bouncing before it got to it.
Davis could certainly have left Higgins something much easier from his miscue.
Clearly no path through to that one that's near the corner. If he had been able to see enough of that, he could have taken the pot on and just slipped across the top cushion behind the black. That is a shot to nothing, but just a little nestle onto it. Well then, if he's straight on this red, well, maybe it doesn't go. I was thinking if he had been able to roll the red in along the cushion, he could have finished on the black, but it mustn't be there, otherwise he would already have been down to play that shot. Well, there clearly you can see not enough room for the red to pot. Mistake from John to catch the knuckles of the middle pocket. But he's left a tester for Steve. You can see enough of the one that's on the blue spot to take it on to the corner. He's looking at the one to the right corner, but it seems to be almost straight. Very little angle here. Well played. But very good pot, but he's straight on the black, so he may refuse it. Can't do much with the cue ball.
Steve Davis, what?
Thought he might as well take the seven extra points if he could, rather than play the safety from the red.
He might just regret that, because I think the red, as close as the white, may go into the middle pocket. I think there's enough of a gap there. Thank you.
One.
But very difficult to do anything now with the cue ball. He's hampered with the red, the black's almost straight. He'll need the spider, so can't do very much with the white.
John Higgins, 8.
Seems to be pretty straightforward to get back down the table, but he's always looking for that spot where he'll put his opponent back into trouble rather than just playing anywhere down the table. Misjudged that time. But it's not all that bad, because the red that he's left on, I don't think John can avoid canning into the other reds. There's a pot to the right corner he could take. That might give him better position. He could find a gap from this one.
Natural angle offered a par through, but the full ball kiss on the pink has left him having to concentrate pretty hard on his next pot. One which in the end
John Higgins
he turned down in favour of the greater certainty of a good safety to the ball cushion.
Yes, I know John Higgins doesn't want to get bogged down with a tactical battle with Steve Davis, but he's well aware and he knows exactly how to beat Steve. He's going to have to compete with him at the safety game, and then when he does get his chance, take it. You can't just sort of have a go at anything against this fellow, because he will punish you if you do that. I think going way back, Clive, to 1993 in the Regal Welsh, I think it might have been one of John Higgins' first finals. Steve Davis beat him 9-3, and I think he learned a great lesson from that.
I was just trying to think. I don't think that Davis has beaten him since.
Yes, they've played nine times, and John Higgins has won seven of the nine meetings.
Could hit Reds direct, but Higgins felt that less could go wrong if he played as if he was snookered.
See, when the balls get like this on the top cushion, there's not a great deal you can do about it to open things up. So. And there again, John Higgins just tapping the table. He does know how to find the difficult positions. I think somewhere near the white line will get him to the safety of that red to the left. Well, it'll do okay that side.
...18 minutes play in this third frame, and that'll suit Davis fine. Whatever he might say, I'm pretty sure he believes that a tight game and the grinding approach offers him his best chance of victory.
Is he going to be tempted? He was, and he hasn't gotten away with it. He didn't get the white around the angles as he intended, so a chance here to break the stalemate. too thick a contact meant that he didn't get the white back down the table, but a chance for John Higgins here.
One.
He didn't get into that at all. He wanted to be the other side of the blue. Looks fairly straight now.
Six. Seven.
Couldn't get above the blue, and let's just look to see how he wants to get on the red to right corner. Pink.
John Higgins, seven.
Much more difficult than blue. Chose it for positional reasons. And has given Davis a chance of a short range pot.
Well, this is not straightforward for Steve either. He's going to have to get... I don't know if the black is available.
One.
Well, it obviously pots. He wanted to be a little bit straighter on it than this. Just let the white run a bit too far. And there, as our camera moves around, you can clearly see it is possible, but... just making sure he gets the correct angle. He's playing it into what we call a blind pocket. Can't see the ball and the pocket together.
Eight.
The fact that the white remained on the black spot has helped things.
Nine.
And suddenly this has developed into not a bad opportunity.
Sixteen.
Tried to develop the red by the middle pocket while retaining position on the blue.
Wanted just a little nudge on that red, and it would have 22. Left him a choice of three or four pots. The fact that he missed the cannon, he just wanted the white to nudge that red there. And as it's turned out, no pot on. So it'll be a matter of trying to find three cushions and try and get over to the yellow. Needs to miss the middle pocket on the way around.
It's Steve Davis, 22.
Plus, as almost always, a good safety.
Foul and a miss. Steve Davis, 4.
That's a costly miss, isn't it? Sometimes you miss and you leave it safe. Obviously the miss is called, but because he's left a choice of reds. So at the moment, advantage to the master tactician.
Yes, Higgins couldn't afford to hit the safety too thick, and ultimately didn't hit it at all.
Whoa.
As he potted the red, he felt he was certain to be on the pink with a chance of returning to the area where the reds are.
What do you think he's going to do here, Clive? Make it tough?
It is a tough snooker, but there's quite a high probability that Higgins will leave everything safe from this.
Foul. Steve Davis, 4.
But no miss called. Was very near, came past the object ball, and there wasn't a more obvious escape. And he's left a cut red.
Well, now then. Expected to knock that one in.
One.
He wanted the angle to be able to disturb the four reds. It's a more delicate shot now. I don't think that red's available to the middle, so we may have to just nudge it slightly. We'll find out if he drops in behind it, there'll be just enough room to pot it, but he might have to disturb it. Well.
John Higgins. Well,
I think he was thinking more about the white than the black there. A little smile to himself. But this game of snooker, if you don't concentrate 100% on every shot, it's amazing just what you can miss.
Well.
Couldn't risk playing it much harder to get above the blue.
Hey. Terrific shot, played with a lot of topspin, and it'd give a banana effect. Just watch the white out and back in again. Terrific shot.
Nine.
So he's looking good now. He's still going to need one of the difficult reds to clinch the frame.
16. 17.
Has he got the angle? When he pots the black, he's having a look at the scoreboard. He'll be 43 in front. There'll still be a possible 43 on the table. So he really needs one of these reds. And he's got a bit of angle. He might be able to cannon the one that's nearest to the pocket.
So this is effectively frame ball.
25.
Higgins made to pay for missing a simple black from its spot.
Steve Davis, 32. Frame conceded. Frame, Steve Davis.
Steve Davis leads John Higgins by 2 frames to 1.
So 3 frames completed of the scheduled 25 in this second round match. We'll be back for the next frame in a moment, but let's just remind you that there are 4 players already through to the quarterfinals. Jimmy White, of course, is one of them in pursuit of that elusive world title. Now here he is at the practice table with someone you might recognise, someone not particularly renowned for his snooker, but Prince Nazim does enjoy the game and of course usually drops in the crucible at some point. If you'd like to send a question to Jimmy, by the way, please do so. There's our email address, snooker@bbc.co.uk. And during the mid-session interval this afternoon, we'll be putting some of those questions to Jimmy live in our studio, snooker@bbc.co.uk. We'll look forward to hearing Jimmy's answers, and he of course is now looking forward to playing either Matthew Stevens or Alan McManus, whose match gets underway tonight. Dominic Dale will play either John Parrott or Joe Swale. Bottom half of the draw, already through to the last 8, are Mark Williams, who'll face now Fergal O'Brien, and it's Ken Doherty or Anthony Hamilton against the winner of the match we're watching this afternoon. Steve Davis 2-1 up after 3 frames. Here's frame 4, the last before the mid-session interval, once again with Dennis and Clive.
Frame 4, Steve Davis to break.
So far, this match being played to a tempo of Davis's liking. The frame durations 19, 21 and 31 minutes respectively.
Well, maybe that shot from John Higgins tells a little story. He had a couple of options. He decided to take the option to open the reds up substantially, and he's managed to get a good white.
Ball over the awkward, more congested side of the table.
There is a path back down the table for Steve. The 2 reds to the left of the black spot that are close together. You can find a gap back down the right side of those. I think he would avoid the red and blue. In fact, the one in front of that, he could even find the gap off that. He was just looking to see if it would knock the other red towards the pocket. It's a half chance of a very difficult plant, but it's the white he's concerned about here. Ah, can John,
foul.
I was going to say, can John get through to the red
four.
That's near the corner pocket? If he spots it right next to the yellow, might just be able to get through.
Whoa.
I'm not sure that Higgins intended to go through that gap between the two reds under the pink. And he certainly didn't intend to cannon the yellow.
Six.
Still got a pot available, but the one just to the right of the black. But he's got to find the gap again. I think he can manage to avoid the two reds there, just to the right of it. That's unlucky.
Foul. John Higgins, six. Steve Davis, four.
Perfect pot on the red. Managed to avoid the cannon, but well, to get the white round and into the middle, a bit unfortunate there.
Red attempted as a shot to nothing. Cue ball always coming back into balk. Possible red to left corner.
I think he's looking at the one that's closest to the pocket to see if there's a gap between two reds to get to the potting angle of that. That looks all very risky. You may just decide on the safety shot, but as you can see, just enough room for that, but I think he was always going to play this shot here. Didn't want to cannon the green and has left a possible shot to nothing for John. One to the right of the pink, can have a go at it in the left corner. The white will head back down towards the brown.
Should be able to avoid the double kiss here. And right-hand side, check the cue ball off the cushion to avoid coming the back red. A perfectly judged safety yet again from the old master.
Yes, and just a few shots ago, the balls were all nicely situated. Now they're starting to get a little bit congested.
That will suit Davis absolutely fine.
Containing safety, but John will be well aware of he won't have very far to walk for his next shot. He'll be on that bottom cushion again.
Turned out that it wasn't one of Davis's better safeties. I didn't think that he would leave Higgins a shot at that one.
Players that manage to get right to the top of the game are players that can have a safety battle, and then when they do get the chance, they can start knocking the pots in. It's not an easy thing to do when you've played quite a lot of tactical play, and then just to go straight back into your nice flowing potting action.
Nine. Ten.
Another quality which is needed is the ability to retain concentration not only when they're at the table, but when they're sitting out. The trick is not to let your attention wander.
16.
When your opponent's at the table.
17.
That's a good point there, Clive. And this Embassy World Championship lasts for 17 days. And although you're not playing every day, you've got to be fully concentrated for the whole tournament. And this gentleman at the table already has won the Embassy World Championship, and the fella sitting watching, well, we all know that he has won it on six occasions. Just looking to see if he can leave that red, because his plan would be to leave an angle, and then he could open the others up and still retain position on the pink. Oh, John
Higgins.
Now that was a lapse in concentration. He was thinking so much about the positional side of the shot, he missed a sitter. He doesn't miss many shots like this, I can assure you. And Now Steve Davis can open the reds up when potting this one.
One.
Could have done with coming back a bit further.
Six.
He's okay, although he's the wrong side of the blue. He's got the little bit of insurance of the red near the corner pocket there. This is a three-session quarterfinal. 2 8-frame sessions and a 9-frame session. The mid-session interval is coming up after this frame, and you tend to play it in sessions. You think to yourself, if I could lead 3-1, you know, that's your plan. Anything else would be a bonus. But I'm sure Steve would be quite comfortable at 2 each, but 3-1, he'd be very pleased.
This is the most interesting
12
juncture of the match so far, because Davis does have a chance to take a 3-1 lead here. But one of the remaining reds, favourably situated.
Thirteen.
Pink and black are not. But he can still score with reds and blues.
Nineteen.
And every break of substance that we've seen from Davis today has resulted from an error by Higgins when he's been in. Oh.
Steve Davis, 19.
What a chance Davis had there.
One.
It's very difficult though for John Higgins with the blue more or less out of commission also. We had to go for the brown there. And he was awkwardly placed there, stretching over the blue. Didn't get the power into the shot. Played for the red that's just above the black spot.
Perhaps should have played that last shot with the rest, as he was on the stretch.
Six.
Good recovery.
John Higgins, six.
Sixteen.
exactly how he played it. Used swerve and the cushion.
Yes, he did well to get the red safe up there, because when you play that type of shot, you're never really sure what's going to happen. That's not the best shot that John's ever played. I think he may get past the yellow, but well, having another look at it, it's very tight. He might have to just bend this slightly, and then he wouldn't be guaranteed to pot it. He'd settle to be able to just hit it thin and bring the white back down and leave the red safe.
Foul and a miss.
That's all gone wrong.
Six.
Didn't need to hit it all that thin.
One.
Well, this is a tricky little black up the cushion. 24 the difference. So he needs the red with the black to secure this frame before the mid-session interval. He won't have to do too much with the cue ball. He's got to give this full attention. The red. Steve Davis would need two snookers.
Nine.
And he might just roll up to the pink here, having a quick look at the scoreboard. Well, he's going to pop the yellow. He's more or less safe in this fourth frame.
Couple of costly errors.
11
from Davis in this frame. He's missed a blue off the spot, and attempting a thin safety, he missed the red altogether.
13.
It's been a hard battle so far, though.
31. John Higgins, 13.
An hour and 32 minutes for four frames, and Davis battling on in this one.
52. Yes, I think the fact that the blue and pink are situated as they are is a good chance for snookers. That's provided John Higgins doesn't pop this green. Where's the brown? Where's the green? They're all heading towards the pockets. Well, just looking at the situation, if the green had been closer to the pocket, he would have potted the green, he would have potted the brown, and then he would have had the perfect opportunity to get in behind the pink off the blue. Might still be able to do that, but he's got to get the white over to the right side of the table. And he has.
Seven.
Yes. He knows his way around the snooker table, this fella, doesn't he?
Steve Davis, seven.
I think he's got to get maybe even a little bit closer to the middle pocket, but somewhere along the lines there might get him to the blue. Very close to the middle, or the corner pocket, rather.
A bit disheartening when you lay such a good snooker as that and your opponent hits it. If Davis doesn't win this frame, his attempt to do so is all part of the grinding process. Make your opponent work for everything.
Well, Clive, if Steve wins this frame, I'll buy you a coffee at the interval.
You know they're free in the press room. Anyway,
five.
All that academic. An hour and 36 minutes for four hard-fought frames. And it's two all at the mid-session
five,
interval.
Conceded, frame, John Higgins.
And then grotting four frames it was too, and they finish all square and go into the mid-session interval. We, of course, will be mid-session interval. They were all square at two frames all, so let's pick it up on their return. It's John Higgins to break in frame five, and just to remind you that our commentators on this one are Dennis Taylor and Clive Everton.
So play underway again after the mid-session interval. This is the midway point of the opening session. Two more sessions in this match, tomorrow morning and tomorrow evening. Few things more encouraging than that. To bang in a long red, clean as a whistle.
Steve Davis, one.
Avoided cannoning another ball. Could have finished on a balk colour. But having potted the red was always going to have the option of the snooker.
Ball under miss. Davis, four.
Badly misjudged and could be a costly one. Four loose reds.
One.
But the shot that got Steve in here, the long red, well, when he starts knocking those in, he's a force to be reckoned with.
Steve Davis?
Would you believe it?
One.
Misses a straightforward pink. And that's just been the problem over the last couple of years, Clive, with Steve's game.
One.
More unforced errors.
Well, you'll have to sit there and watch the outcome of this. A lot of bottom, pot the blue straight into the red at the front of the bunch. We'll open them right up.
Six. Seven.
Yes, he played that split on the red so well to John Higgins. The first player that played the shot that way with lots of screw and bottom was Stephen Hendry, and well, John Higgins has played thousands of frames against Stephen Hendry since turning pro. Don't practice together these days, but
12.
In the meantime, John's played a very loose safety shot, positional stroke. Suppose it could be classed a safety shot.
He wasn't meaning to play safety on himself.
You know what I mean though, Clive.
John Higgins, 12.
So, Davis has got off lightly from his unforced error. Well, I don't know what he was attempting, but he didn't attempt to hit it like that.
Yes, he had a lot of screw inside on it, hoping to get the other side of the yellow-green brown, but it'll do where it is unless John pulls out. Well, he didn't even consider taking the long pot on there. That was very well played, that shot. The natural angle would have took him into the reds there, but he played it with plenty of pace, and it did swing the white away. Now, is he unlucky?
Four.
Can he get through to the red for the left corner? If he can, this is a terrific opportunity.
Five.
Should knock a few in here.
Twelve. 13.
He is a very good break builder, John Higgins. We did see that in his match against Dave Harrell, but he had a 64 in the opening frame, but didn't have many chances after that.
Yes, Davis has kept him out pretty well, but it's still 2-2, and Higgins going strongly towards a 3-2 lead here.
21.
Now the question is whether Higgins can strike the centre of the cue ball to the side of the red. Well, got to get slightly over the top of it.
Yes, he was very restricted, as you could see, and couldn't avoid the cannon onto the red. It's a little bit more tricky than the one to the right of the pink would have been.
John Higgins, 28.
So just 28 from that very good chance. As I said, he was hoping to be on the one, the other side of the pink, but couldn't get to that because he was hampered when potting the black.
May have been a bit worried about cannoning the black, and in avoiding that hit the red much too thick. So Higgins left right in with a chance to clinch the frame.
One. Nine. Sixteen.
He's having a quick look at the score. He's 50 points in front, so he'll probably go for the blue this time.
17.
The frames pretty safe. Still needs one more red, but he's not going to miss this one.
22.
And just from a psychological point of view, that red that Steve Davis missed, well, he knows it's cost him this frame. He had a chance to get back into it. He'll have to put that out of his mind fairly quickly.
31. 38. John Higgins, 38. Frame conceded. Frame, John Higgins.
Davis led 2-1, but two frames, one either side of the mid-session interval, have put John Higgins 3-2 ahead.
Nine. Seventeen.
Playing this with a lot of pace, try and open the reds because they're a little bit awkward with them being a bit square there, so he needs to catch them with plenty of pace on this. It's a bit unlucky that.
24.
Starting to cue very well indeed, John Higgins. Got the perfect angle on the blue, and if he can avoid the pink and cannon straight into that red at the front of the bunch, it will really open things up. 30. Smoothly and very confidently.
Hit the bunch perfectly. The black remains unprotected by any red.
31.
So there's a high probability of a frame-winning break from Higgins here. Not so much now.
38.
Well, I think he might have had a bad contact, but he's usually very reliable in that type of shot. Let's just see if we can detect. Well, just cue ball leapt in the air, so that's took the pace out of it. Hence, he's close to the cushion.
38 scored.
And this isn't straightforward. Got to be a bit careful. He's cannoning the other reds. Should finish on blue or ball colour.
39.
And if the pink pots, that's a bonus. There you go. Well, that last shot, very well played.
Forty-six. 53.
Well, not perfect. Had he been straighter on red to middle, or had the cue ball a little nearer the right-hand side cushion for this red, to leave a bit of an angle, that would have been perfect. Still perfectly all right. Just had a fraction of angle to come out onto the black.
Yes, a good chance here of a sizable break for John Higgins. His main concern will be to clinch the frame. There's a possible 144, as you can see. At the moment, John Higgins currently holds the high break along with Joe Swell. A break of 141. So at the moment they would share the £20,000 high break prize. And he'd be well aware of that with John Higgins now that the frame is safe. He'd concentrate on making as many as possible.
78.
Well, he wanted a fuller contact on the red. He's still on the pink. Just makes the next pot a lot more difficult.
84.
One to the middle.
On the blue, but now he can only tie the highest break.
91.
Well, that would be most unusual if he'd made another 141.
Higgins has, of course, made two 147s in competition this season.
99.
One in the Nations Cup and one in the Irish Masters.
And I had the great pleasure, Clive.
106.
Of playing John Higgins in the Nations Cup and sitting and watching him make his first maximum break. So that was an absolute delight for me to see.
116.
Higgins has taken these with great authority. Dropped slightly out of position a couple of times, but it's made no difference.
Yes, what a break, and £20,000. Well, does he share it three ways?
123.
He'll get two-thirds of it.
128.
Unless it's beaten, which I think it will be.
134. 141 for Frey, John Higgins.
The superb total clearance of 141 by John Higgins. He leads Steve Davis by 4 frames to 2.
John Higgins playing beautifully, and his second 1-4-1, three 1-4-1s in total. We reckon that could be a first ever. 1-4-1 is the highest break, and if it stays that way, we have now had it confirmed from the tournament office that the prize will be split two-thirds to John Higgins and one-third to Joe Swale, because Higgins has done the 1-4-1 twice. Who knows, it may yet be overtaken before the end of the championship and resolve the problem. So despite that second 1-4-1 by John Higgins, he's no longer the favourite to win this Embassy World Championship. These are the latest title odds. Mark Williams is now the favourite at 15-8, John Higgins at 12-5. Then it's Matthew Stevens at 3-1, Ken Doherty 9-1. The reason, apparently, despite the fact that Higgins is beating Steve Davis, is that Mark Williams is a stage further in the championship, of course. He's already into the quarterfinals. And there also is perhaps the feeling that Mark has the easier of the quarterfinal ties. He will play Fergal O'Brien. John Higgins, should he beat Davis, will face either Ken Doherty or Anthony Hamilton. That, we're told from William Hills, is the reason why Mark Williams is now the favourite to win this Embassy World Championship. So let's get back to the Higgins-Davis match then, and we're into frame seven with John Higgins to break.
Thank you. Frame seven. John Higgins to break.
Davis has scored only 6 points in the last two frames. Making sure he covered the red nearest the ball line. Even if Davis had been able to play a return to Bork, it would have been a tricky one with the red near the green. Maybe he can get that outside edge. Containing safety.
It's close to being touching the red, but he may still be able to see the potting angle of the one to the right of your picture there. And he could play it as a shot to nothing, could finish on the black. As long as he doesn't move the red that's closest to the cue ball, the one that's touching. It's always worth a risk at that one. But it's too risky. The one that Steve Davis could take on, the one to the left of the pink on its own, he could pot it up past the two reds. But if he missed it, he'd leave the pot on for that pocket.
Higgins again using the green to good effect. Snookering Davis on the two most important reds.
Well, it might just be time for Steve Davis to try and close up shop again here, because the last two frames he hasn't had a chance. Magnificent 141. The frame only lasted over 9 minutes, and the one before that was just under 13 minutes. The fact that the reds are getting pushed up towards the other end of the table is an indication that it'll take a while to resolve. Might be tempted here to have a go at the one to the left middle, but it's a very acute angle, and there's a possibility of leaving the red at the back of the bunch around the pink. And never easy to pot it at that pace.
Yes, and Higgins was quite happy to leave him that one, because he played his own red for black ball position, knowing that he would leave his opponent a shot at the other one if he missed.
Giving it a bit of thought here, because just to roll to that red, you'd have to be very careful. You could leave one potable. The advantage here is with John Higgins, quite easy to get the white back behind the black, but he wants it tight on the cushion. Oh, that's not a good shot. In fact, I'm just wondering if the two reds to the right of the bunch, Steve might be able to take them on as a plant. He's had a look at them, but maybe not, but at least he can get the white back behind the black. There was a red there. It was a similar result, but just enough room for that one to pass. But he was putting a lot of emphasis on the safety side of it as well. Advantage Steve Davis now.
Well,
it took 7 minutes 40 seconds to get the first red of this frame in the pocket.
Well, he may be able to have a go at a red into the same pocket as the one he potted previously, if he had an angle to get back for the black, but obviously not. He's got to be careful here. He doesn't bring the red back up the table. He'll use one of the others to knock this one onto. Played it well. Advantage John Higgins now. Similar type shot, but Steve's got to get a lot more power. He's got to be careful not to bring one up, so he'll use another red as a stopper again. But he hasn't got the white back to where he wanted. There's a chance here for John. If he gets the pot, he'll be on the black.
One. Nine.
It's just a wee bit complicated at the moment, the two reds hampering the blue. Pink's out of commission.
11.
But he can bring the blue into play now, just one pot, little cannon.
12.
And now they're sitting pretty.
Seventeen. 18.
Well, Clive, I think this spells danger for Steve Davis. He's looking in fine form now, John Higgins.
23.
Yes, Davis was 2-1 up, but he made a couple of mistakes.
24.
In the fourth frame and lost it, and Higgins has been dominant ever since. If he makes the most of this opportunity, he'll go three clear at 5-2.
29. Thirty-five. 36.
He's okay here, the red at the back of the three reds and pinks available to the opposite corner. Just a little bit short of pace, but when he plays this, he'll open the three up and should finish on the black.
44.
Really is a class player when
51.
You watch him like this.
52.
He's queuing well. He's highly focused. He's on the brink of a 5-2 lead.
57.
Yes, he's got an awful lot to play for here this year. He lost his Embassy title to Stephen Hendry last year. He's lost his number one world ranking to Mark Williams. So he's very highly focused.
Although Williams is certain to be number one in the end of season rankings, Higgins is going to be number two because he's overtaken Stephen Hendry.
66.
Hendry having lost in the first round.
Yes, short of pace, he's going to struggle now to make back-to-back centuries. This is a thin one.
John Higgins, 67. Great completed. Great, John Higgins.
Trouble for Davis. A 5-2 lead for Higgins.
And John Higgins has now taken four frames in a row, so it is trouble for Steve Davis. Well, frame eight, the last one of the session today, has already been in progress for some 26 minutes, and John Higgins is 31-1 now ahead. Steve Davis having just potted that red. So let's immediately rejoin our commentary team for an update.
Steve Davis, one.
This frame has been in progress 26 minutes and has been an orgy of safety play. Hardly any potting.
It has been fascinating though, Clive, hasn't it? Because the brown and the yellow were knocked tight on the cushion. Nothing to play behind. And that would be a miss.
Foul and a miss. Steve Davis, four.
But a couple of times, Steve has managed to get the white in behind the yellow, even though there's very little room.
His safety play has been masterly, but he's undermined that with three or four unforced errors in the potting department.
Foul and a miss. Steve Davis, six.
Yes, the angle just didn't seem to be there to get in that side of the blue. Miscalled, but obviously Steve has got a chance to pot the red. As you can see, he was very close to it, but
foul and a miss.
It's left a chance for Steve to develop the pink or the black here, or maybe even both.
One.
This is the frame which defines Davis's day's work. If he can win it, he trails only 5-3 overnight. If he loses it, he's four frames adrift.
Seven. Steve Davis. Seven.
Well, dropping it in dead wet, there's always a chance that it can just drift a little bit on the nap of the cloth, and not a good shot from Steve. He had nothing to do with the cue ball. The blue was awaiting over that middle pocket. But this is awkward for John. He might need the spider. He's got to be careful. It's a long stretch, that. It's pretty slim, but I don't think he's going to be able to reach this, is he? A little smile from him.
The rest, he wouldn't have minded, but he did want to avoid using the spider.
And look at the way he's using it. Very well played, John Higgins. Not often you see the spider turned up that way. Maybe all these years, Clive, we've been using it the wrong way.
Well,
seven.
The idea there was to use it in such a way,
eight,
as to use minimum elevation needed. To obviate the effect of striking downwards.
Forty.
But the unconventional use of the spider has given Higgins a chance to clinch this last frame of the day.
19.
He's just had a quick glance at the scoreboard, as has Steve. Just working out what he needs after the pink.
20.
Well, he needed the pink and one more red, and he might have fluked the pink. Where's it going? Not quite.
John Higgins, 20.
So still a glimmer of hope for Steve Davis in this final frame of this session. He's missed very little this afternoon.
Well,
the pot was pretty straightforward. Three-quarter ball. Had to stun back for the remaining ready needed, but that could make a two-frame distance. If Davis could now snatch the frame.
Of course, John, still a firm favourite, you'd have to say, with the position of the colours. And this is a tricky little one, and he needs a little bit of pace just to come out off the cushion with the cue ball.
7.
I think
seven.
That has virtually sealed the fate of this eighth frame.
1.
Higgins came to the table needing just the last red in any colour to leave Davis needing a snooker. Blue would be a certainty. Green is a near certainty.
A bit of a blow for Steve Davis, because he won the tactical battle in this frame and then missed that straightforward red into the middle pocket. But it is the best of 25, so although he's four frames behind, who knows what Steve Davis could pull out tomorrow morning.
John Higgins, six.
Which leaves Davis needing two snookers. It's been an interesting session, quite slow at times, 2 hours 50 minutes total, but some fascinating safety play.
Three.
And another highlight, a 1-4-1 total clearance by Higgins.
John Higgins, three.
35 the difference, 22 on the table.
Well, I think he now needs four snookers. He's got one of them. This is not straightforward. He needs a little bit of side coming off the top cushion to hit the brown. Not quite. At the moment, Steve Davis needs four-point snookers, and then he'd have to pot brown, blue, pink, and black to win the frame by 1 point. Very, very high odds.
Another snooker, but not difficult to hit for a player of this caliber.
So I think I got my calculations just a little bit wrong, but he still needs four snookers.
Been the afternoon's play, which has illustrated that it doesn't matter how good your tactical game is, you can't win if you don't pop the balls when you get the chance.
See, when we talk about Steve needing four snookers, he's already had three snookers and John's escaped from every one of them, so that means he would need a lot more snookers.
He won't be playing for snookers now.
Nine.
Steve Davis was 2-1 up, but John Higgins took the remaining five frames of the afternoon to lead by 6 frames to 2 overnight.
Looking good for the 1998 world champion, and that last frame was...
I call it Essex boys camping.
Indeed, that will set off a few arguments, I'm sure. So Joe Swale has already provided a huge story here today with that remarkable comeback to beat John Parrott. Let's find out what was happening in the other table this morning between John Higgins and Steve Davis. And of course, for all the players who come here to the Crucible, you're under the spotlight in a big way in front of 1,000 people here in the arena, millions watching on television. But off the table, it's a rather different story. John Higgins explains how you just fill those long hours between sessions.
It's difficult after a long match to come back to your hotel room and your head's still spinning, you're still on a high, and you can remember every single shot. Whereas if the same person asked you maybe 2 weeks down the line if you remembered these shots, you probably wouldn't remember them because you're so much focused into the next match and the next match and the next match. It does flash by, but then again, the good bits always stick. The better players, they remember the mental scars and they remember certain shots that have cost them matches, and it's up to yourself to actually try and erase them for your memory and try to do the right thing. It is quite a hard sport sometimes. One ball can mean the difference. You've been world champion and been a nobody. So sometimes it is very hard to go over it. Sport and you're hopeful. You've got to try and get the most out of it as what you possibly can. When I suppose you're going to beat your peak soon. Well, I'm going to be 25, and people say you reach your peak around about 27, 28, 29. So hopefully now I can maybe do some more damage.
The hours hang heavy for Higgins, and of course he's up against a Crucible legend in Steve Davis, who's been coming here, as you can see, since 1979, lost to Dennis Taylor then, and then of course that astonishing run of success in the 86 World Championships. Not since 1989, and in fact, as Steve has got a little bit older, his record clearly has declined a little. He's not reached the last eight since 1996, there it was, against Peter Ebdon. Round two in 97, lost to the eventual winner, lost to Mark Williams 2 years ago. Last year went out in the first round to Joe Perry. And of course, he's now got a very tough one on his hands against the world number one for the last 2 years. 6-2, remember, after their opening session in favour of John Higgins. But Steve got off to a good start this morning. He took the opening frame, 73-39. So it's 6-3 as we pick it up in frame 10 of the match. It's John Higgins at the table, 36-24 behind. Commentating on this one, John Virgo and Ray Edmonds.
Nine.
shot.
16.
Knew he'd be on this red and took the opportunity to open the others. So they're nicely spread now for a frame-winning contribution.
17.
And so far, this has been an excellent start to the morning for Steve Davis. OK, John Higgins has missed a couple of opportunities, but Steve looks to be queuing quite nicely. See, 36 ahead, still 59 remaining, so a couple of reds, a couple of colours is what's required.
25.
And, well, funny things can happen, but it looks a formality.
The difference now 50 points, just 43 on, so 38. Looking forward to take this plant on. There's a bit of distance between the reds, but they're pretty well in line.
39.
So, as John was saying, it's been a pretty good start, but it's unforced errors from John Higgins that would most concern him and his supporters. He's not made the errors necessarily from Steve putting pressure on him. He's missed a few pots and
45.
They've cost him any chance of winning one of the two opening
46.
Frames. But take nothing away from Steve Davis. He's doing the job pretty efficiently.
51.
Well, I was just saying his breaks weren't much above 30, but he had a 51 in frame 2.
53.
So this is the highest he's had, and exactly the right time.
56. Sixty-five.
Well, that was a lovely positional shot. Look at break this has been.
71.
71. Well, they were there, but he made them absolutely impeccably. And Steve Davis pulls another one back. He's just two behind now at 6-4 to John Higgins.
Yes, what a confident start to the morning by Steve Davis, and he's looking good as well in the next frame, frame 11 of the match. Steve's at the table, and he's leading 53-0.
53-0. Well, John Higgins hasn't been potting anything like as well as we expect, particularly with the long ones, but he's got another long pot here to the left corner. He's sure to be on the black, you would think. And if he knocks it in, suddenly that 53-point lead wouldn't look insurmountable at all.
One.
bit ironic if the only real error Steve's made this morning, which was that positional shot, was to lead to him losing from this situation, but certainly not beyond John Higgins. In fact, if he hadn't missed a few this morning, John, you'd say he's nearly favourite from this position.
Well, absolutely, Ray. I was just thinking, on all known form, in these situations, you'd expect John Higgins to win the frame. I'm not trying to make it sound easy. I'm just basing it on what we see tournament after tournament. And it wasn't much of a mistake by Steve, apart from the fact he didn't take his chance when he had it.
60.
He played a shot for nothing, just hit it a little bit too thin. The cue ball bounced a little bit more off the ball cushion than he would have liked. And he left a long red, which certainly wasn't easy. But once John 70. Knocked it in, Steve probably, as we are, right, feeling the worst for him.
Yeah, I'm sure he's feeling the worst. He's
23.
He'll be hoping, but not realistically, of getting back to the table.
24.
But there's all kinds of things can happen. You get the kick, a lapse of concentration. So, as John says, it's not straightforward. It's just that you don't expect John to miss from this.
31.
Oh, any colour, but he's, well, the pink, as good as any, and then he'll need yellow, green, brown, and the blue. And the pink, sorry. So he needs up to 46. And including the pink. Well, Steve, he looks in good touch, but that one mistake looks to have cost him dearly.
51.
Just come on the wrong side of the blue to get close to the pink. So just a glimmer of hope perhaps for Steve.
60.
So this a real pressure shot for the world number one. One error from Steve, it's costly. 7-4 now to John Higgins.
And John's first frame of the morning. These two have met 15 times. Steve Davis has won only four of them, the most recent of which was all of 5 years ago. So that's a measure of the task which faces him against John Higgins. Here's the next frame. Davis, as you can see, leading 24-2. But he's taking his time about this one, as you can see, almost 2 minutes in consideration of this shot.
Them, they become the messy shot, and I think that one did there for Steve, but actually it's not so bad, is it?
Well, I think it's not too bad, because the reddy's knocked down and stopped the black going along the top cushion into the right corner, but for that the black was on, and it could have been a dangerous situation. Sorry for laughing, it was just the look on Steve's face that amused me. So we carry on. The red will obviously pot into the right corner, but it's fraught with danger. No guarantee of being in on a colour, and he can get through to reds on the left-hand side of the table to play safe. But he's deciding to go for this pot. He needs to get it. Is he on the black? Is he on the black? Just. Now, if he can get this, this is a great chance to win the frame. Give himself a chance now.
Eight.
Yeah, I think he's got a bit of a problem, though. This one down the right is pretty well straight. And it's a thinnish cut, the one near the left corner. It could get back for the black into the same pocket, but he's got very little margin of error, and played at pace. Well, he's got to get it absolutely perfectly.
Nine.
Well, didn't have much control there of where it was going to go, and now he's faced with a very difficult problem. He can probably get through to the black, and I think he's forced to take it on, because any other way he'd leave this red near the left corner. So this is a big shot for Steve. Well, one or two very good shots in that little sequence, and can he go on now and really take full advantage of them?
Yes, you've got to take your hat off. He's certainly battling, and he's giving every shot 100% concentration. Well, it's very straight, deep screw required for black. Oh, well played. Couldn't strike that any better, even in his peak.
Twenty-five.
So the black and one more red, and you have won three of the first four frames this morning.
32.
John Higgins has made a few mistakes, but I'm sure he's not too concerned yet. He still holds a, or still will hold a two-frame advantage.
33.
six Embassy titles have been won by Steve Davis, and he's fighting desperately hard to really get back into this match. So maybe keep hope is alive. His hopes Steve alive Davis, of a 40, seventh, and
he's really done very well this morning. Three out of the four frames played. He's reduced the deficit to just two at 7-5 to John Higgins.
Steve Davis making a real fight of it, as everyone, including John Higgins, knew that he would. So let's move on into the next frame then. Only two in it, and it's Steve Davis to play. John Higgins has already scored four.
Well, that couldn't have worked out much better. With the black and pink being a little awkward, he's got a lot of work to do, but quite a few reds to choose from.
Thirteen. 18. Thank you.
Well, the time before he was short on the blue, this time he's gone too far. So he's just struggling to keep good control of that cue ball at the moment. The red just below the pink will pot into the left corner.
24.
This will clear the pink area. So it's doing, or he's recovered good position.
Well, the pink now available into both middles, and also I think it'll probably go to the left corner. So things somewhat easier for John now.
32.
Well, this is the tricky one. He'll play it dead weight, so that should he miss it, he'll cover the pocket to that red in the picture there, but you'd expect him to knock it in.
Well, this is a good chance. Just needs a couple more good positional shots. You can see the ready before you saw in the side pocket. And that looks to be perfect.
47.
So 51 points to lead. Three reds, two of them with colours, should be more than enough.
48.
And he's played this frame well. Coming first with a good long red and... 30. And when he did run out of position, he played a good safety.
55.
And Steve... Well, it was only a fraction out with his safety shot, but he left him a long red. John Higgins knocked it in, and this time he's made no mistake, or doesn't appear to.
56.
Just needing black and one more red. Steve Davis will need a couple of snookers.
Well, obviously it's essential John knocks the red in, the positional side of the shot not so important this time.
71,
72, 79. He's already 80. Had two breaks of 141 in this year's Embassy World Championship, and at the moment tying with Joe Swale for two-thirds of the available prize. So, 87. He's had a 141 earlier on 88. In this match, one of those breaks, so still heavily scoring when he gets the chance.
93. 94.
So nicely on the pink. On the pink will give him the 100. 100. Excellent contribution.
100.
Never really looked in trouble from the moment he knocked the long red in.
102. 105. 109.
So he'd had 181 centuries in his career before the start of this match. It's now 183. High on the all-time list.
120.
And really. It has been a superbly constructed clearance.
Seven, place to seven, and three, John Higgins.
And John Higgins goes back three clear again now, and it's 8-5.
Yes, John Higgins' second century break of the match, and as Ray said, he now leads by three again at 8-5. Here's frame 14. Once again, it's looking good for Higgins. 56-0 in front. Steve Davis at the table.
Well, it's not straightforward for John Higgins. No return to balk down the right-hand side of the table. The pink's on the making that awkward. Possibility of a pot, but this is no gimme. This is very difficult. Oh, great pot. What a pot that was. And no wonder Steve is thinking how safe he's got to get the balls, because, well, if John Higgins starts to pot those regular, then is there a safe place on the table?
Nine. 40. 50.
So that very good opening red is made absolutely sure. John Higgins going back into a four-frame lead, and that really is going to make the task very, very difficult for
23.
Steve Davis. He just missed two or three balls in the first two frames this morning, and Steve took control.
37.
And John Higgins really is a delight to watch when he gets in to a break-building mood. He really does retain very good control of the cue ball.
58.
And pretty quickly at that.
64.
So, second successive frame for Steve Davis that he's not potted a ball. John Higgins now.
John Higgins.
Comfortable at 9-5 in front.
Yes, despite Steve's excellent start, John Higgins has restored that four-frame advantage with which he began the session, and we'll bring you the final two frames of that session of play in the mid-session interval this afternoon. We're now beginning to turn our attention to live play here at the Crucible. Two matches scheduled today.
Thirty-one.
36.
Well, absolute perfection. They've broken nicely, hit it well. Well, that just shows you the superiority that John Higgins has had in the last three frames. Steve Davis not potted a red. 2.5 frames while John scored over 300 points, and he's still in with a chance of scoring a fair few more.
49.
And this started with a very cheeky plant, a risky one you would have thought, but it wasn't a problem. And I don't think John Higgins can play a deal better than he's playing at the moment.
56.
No, I certainly agree with that. He's, well, he's just been relentless.
57.
And just a slight mistake. I mean, as you say, it looked a very risky plant. It's just his confidence is so high. 64. Particularly after losing three of the first four frames, he's come out after the mid-session interval and
64.
Well, he's not missed a ball.
65.
So just the black, and that's this frame safely in the bag.
72.
And Steve, well, what can you do? Didn't even make a mistake, I don't think, in this frame.
78.
Another cheeky plant. Just not a problem, is it? And you do well to play like this in a practice session, never mind on the biggest stage of them all.
93. 94. 99. 100.
His third century of this match is 184th. in his career.
102. 104. 107. 111.
Not absolutely sure what the record is of points scored without your opponent replying.
116.
But if John Higgins gets the black, it'll be 387 points without reply from Steve Davis. Phenomenal scoring by John Higgins. Steve Davis with a lot to contemplate. Five frames clear for the first time in this match. 10-5 to the Scot.
John Higgins' seventh century break, and he's only played a match in three quarters, a total of 33 frames. Stunning snooker from the former champion. Seven centuries, including the two 1-4 ones, which are jointly the high break best with Joe Swale. He's also had 370s, 560s, 440s, and 530s. Terrifically consistent scoring by John Higgins. More importantly, he leads going into the final frame of the session by five frames, and how badly Steve Davis wants this one. He started well, 41-15 in front.
That could be the frame winning shot. It's going to be very difficult to John, for John to hit a red and not leave Steve a chance here. He's looking if he can drop on the right-hand side of the two reds together, but well, he's not only going to get the direction, but the pace absolutely perfect. He's hit the pink, has he? Oh, he's gone on the inside of it.
Steve Davis, four.
No miss will be taken, of course. 30 points in front. Frame-winning chance.
One.
Well, that wasn't a bad kiss on the yellow. And with the brown. And he looks to have a nice angle on it. Shouldn't be a problem potting it and coming back for the reds. Now, I'm certain Steve won't let this chance slip. Three of these remaining reds, and they're nicely in the open. Two with a colour would be more than enough.
Six. Fourteen.
Well, just a little bit pacey. Would have liked to have a nice easy blue to the middle and just stunned down for the last red, so. Still needs another red after this. Now, these two are planked to the corner. I don't think they're far off being in line. And as Steve only needs the red to 90. Make sure. And really, 20. He's done very well, Steve Davis, to win four of this morning's frames, because John Higgins had a storm in three-frame sessions 13, 14 and 15.
27.
And, well, maybe Steve winning this is just keeping in touch. There's going to be the four-frame gap.
28.
Which opened in the first session. If he'd have gone six down, you couldn't really have given him a chance. But four, well, just within touching distance.
35.
Intriguing. Morning session. There was no pressure on it, but it's still a wonderful pot.
Forty-three. 45. 48.
He had a 78 break in frame 10, which is easily his best of the match.
52.
Steve Davis to take the last frame of this second session, but it ends as it begun with John Higgins, four frames clear, the score 10-6.
And they will play it to a finish this evening.
To 2-7. And Davis is at the table, and he's ahead. Clive Everton, Dennis Taylor commentate, Barry White's the referee.
One.
He's overrun his intended red by quite some distance.
Well, can he get it right this time? That was a very good recovery pot there. He feels the green's a better one, but I think he can get back up off the brown to this red also. But he prefers the green. Maybe just a little bit straighter on the brown, but... Well, he's a long way short,
seven.
But it could work to his advantage because he now has an angle to cannon the red that's next to the black, so if this works out... Got to pot the red, though.
Seven.
Runs on further than Higgins intended, but this is still a chance to win this frame.
8. John Higgins, 8.
Well, Higgins just can't seem to quite do it at the moment. And Davis, despite a couple of potting errors and one unexpected loss of position, still 8 points in front.
Was a very well executed shot there. Unlucky not to get the snooker. That was one time he would have liked the red to have cannoned one of the ball colors. He would have had a certain snooker, but it isn't. Be a bit careful with this one. He's trying to send the red between yellow and brown and avoid the contact on the green on the way back up. He wants to get the red back towards the black. He may have just changed his mind on that. Now, is he lucky?
Don't think so.
Yes, I think he still should have played his first choice of shots. He just changed his mind at the last minute, and it could cost him this frame.
One.
Bit short of pace again.
4.
Tense stuff out there.
Yes, and Davis is relishing it.
Yes, he may be relishing it, but that's a couple of positional shots that's just let him down a little bit. Trying to sight this correctly. Oh, that's a great shot. What a shot with the rest. He's gone a little bit further than he would have liked, but still it was some shot on the yellow. Needs the brown as well.
Nine.
Played with left of centre striking to the cue ball off the side cushion. So, the frame ball.
Still looking at the scoreboard. He would be making just one snooker required.
Steve Davis, 13.
So, it looks as if Davis has reduced the gap to a single frame.
He had, but not for long, because Higgins won frame 20, 137 points to nil. The two-frame gap was there again, 11-9. Here's frame 21, and this time, Steve Davis is 30 points behind.
No, he's played that well, centred right around the angles. Terrific shot from Steve Davis. The atmosphere in the Crucible Theatre is something special, and John Higgins is going to have to pull something special out here. The yellow's slightly in the road. He's got to go very close to the yellow if he comes off the side cushion. That's what he's looking for. Maybe the first line's not quite right, but he's just got to get past the yellow.
Foul and a miss. Steve Davis, four.
Well, if the cue ball hadn't gone in the pocket, there would have been a good chance of a free ball. But as it is, Higgins is in plenty of trouble.
Still looking just to pass the yellow. Must be able to see enough of the red, you could tell by John's expression there. And that was the pressure creeping in there as well, even with all the experience that Steve has. It's tough out there.
Well,
Davis had a chance to snatch the frame, come close to only one behind at 11-10.
I think that definitely is the big turning point in this match. Still not over yet, but it'll be a relief, John Higgins.
Eight.
And an important mistake earlier from Davis. Mr. Simple Red on 36-0.
11.
And your tactical game can be masterly, but at the end, you have to pot the balls to win.
50. 20.
There was a fleeting moment when it seemed as if Higgins' 66 break in this frame wouldn't be enough.
26.
It wasn't, but he got in again.
34.
Davis popping arrow and now leads by 12 frames to 9. 3 up, 4 to play.
98 champion needing one more. But to the next, Davis had different ideas. He took command of the frame, and Higgins here is 52-0 down and needs to start scoring.
It was a big shot. He knew if he knocked it in, he had a chance the way the balls were situated. He was close, but not close enough. Another chance for Steve Davis.
One.
Well.
4. Five. 12.
So just this red leaves Higgins needing snookers. So Steve Davis sticks to his game, sticks to his method.
20.
And he's going to battle it out to the last.
21. Thirty-one. 32. 38. 39.
Perfectly played. 40. You want to make sure and clear the colours here.
44. 46. 49. 53.
Well, this has been very nice indeed, but he needs more of the same. He's going to snatch victory from defeat.
64. First frame in the match where John Higgins hasn't managed to score a point.
Steve Davis clears with 71 to reduce John Higgins' lead to 12-10.
So the young Scot still needs one with three to play, and the 42-year-old Nugget is still in there, and he's 8-0 up in this one.
Well, he has knocked in some fine pots here. He's missed some easy ones, but overall he really has pulled a few good pots out. Up for the blue this time.
Eight.
don't think he can hold for the black. He'd have to cannon the reds there if he wanted to do that. But he's a straightforward position on the blue, but just depends how he feels.
Nine.
Well, he can say, I saw the great Steve Davis at the Crucible.
Fifty.
Tremendous resolution, this, from the six times world champion of the 80s. Every time John Higgins has opened a significant gap,
20.
Davis has responded. 20. He's never quite closed the gap.
21.
He did get back to only 10-9 behind. But he's sticking to his method, sticking to his game. And he's not out of it yet.
28. 29.
And he's also sticking to that little ritual. Since the opening shot, he sights it, bends down. First time we've seen him do this. He says it just helps him to sight the ball that little bit better, but it's probably a psychological thing, but he's done it on every shot.
35.
There you go.
36.
I think it baffled us all at the beginning, and we've got used to it.
43.
And it's working.
Well, Davis has never stopped looking for even small ways to improve his game.
44.
Or, to put it another way, minimize his rate of decline. Not the player he was in the 80s, but still a fine player.
51.
Well, he's needed a couple of chances in the two previous frames. He might be able to do it with one chance here. This is great stuff from Steve Davis.
59. 60.
And he's going to do it in one hit. He's starting just to get a little bit anxious now, but he's very good under pressure too, this man.
67.
Could have done with being topside of the blue. although he has got this frame in the bag.
Well,
just another fraction on him. Sure, we would have had a century break. He's going to have to pull a little trick shot out here. Back double. Might be there.
Steve Davis clinches the last frame with a break of 71. He clinches that one with a break of 73.
He's now only one behind. John Higgins leads by 12 frames to 11.
How is he doing it? He's getting closer again, and John Higgins standing still into 24 of a possible 25. Higgins 49.5 up. He's on a break of 40 here at the moment.
He's unlucky. Couldn't have played it any better, but he's put them all safe.
45.
...49 in front.
John Higgins, 45.
Behind the green is what he'll be trying. Just a little bit too strong. Still a good shot, but the snooker would have been better. Oh, too thick. But it's not an easy one. Hampered by the pink. He may take it on. No attempt at the pot. Looked as if he missed the pot there, but didn't try it. He's waiting for a better chance. Well, what a situation that faces Steve Davis. The reds are all open. There's a possible pot to the left corner. It's make your mind up time, Steve. Big decision to be made here. What a shot. Under extreme pressure, had he have missed that pot, he would have been out of this year's embassy. He's unlucky. The black is covering the red.
Eight.
He's got one to the left middle. Would have been easier, but the chance is still there.
Steve Davis, 8.
Tough shot, that. But nothing easy left, and perhaps nothing at all. There was room
one
to get through to that red. It was just a fraction the other way, and Higgins wouldn't have had a ball on.
He really is a class act. He had to do it against Dave Harold, pulled all the stops out.
Five.
And he's having to do it against Steve Davis, who has put up a magnificent fight here. He still needs...
Six.
Well, in fact, Steve needs a snooker.
Brown.
The brown safe.
John Higgins, 6.
So that should be a quarter-final place for John Higgins. But certainly not over with only one snooker needed.
Yes, you've got to take your hat off to Steve Davis. Magnificent display against one of the top players in the game, and has been for the last 3-4 years.
Well, Steve Davis has resisted with grit, resolution and skill.
And he'll be the first to congratulate John Higgins, the great sportsman that he is.
8. Nine.
This fine young champion of the 90s, John Higgins, has beaten snooker's greatest champion of the 80s.
16.
Yes, a lot of people thought that John Higgins would steamroller Steve Davis. Steve, as I said, put up a magnificent display here.
21.
But you just can't beat these young guns.
John Higgins, 21.
From three down with four to play. Steve Davis made a great fight of it, but it's John Higgins who goes into the quarterfinals, winner by 13 frames to 11.
Tenth night here, what a good one. The young Scot goes on, and the old Englishman, he goes home. But what a fight he put up. All credit to him for that. That leaves us one place to be filled in the quarterfinal lineup, and that's between Alan McManus and Matthew Stevens. They came out here this afternoon. Stevens almost wrapped it up.
It was very tough. Steve played superbly well, and if that's what it was like, anywhere near the standard he was producing in the mid-80s, now I wouldn't have liked to have played him, because he certainly played really well.
I mean, you couldn't have expected anything like that from him, really, out there tonight, could you?
Being honest, no, because he's not maybe produced that standard over... He's produced it in fits and bursts, fits and starts, but he's never produced it for like the whole 25 frames, and he's certainly played very well.
I would have thought after a couple of sessions, when you got 10-6, you thought, well, I've got over the worst, and he can't keep this going, but he came out at you tonight, I mean, and just shot in the foot for 3 frames.
Exactly. I was very lucky to go 11-9. It looked as if it could have maybe went 10-all, and it's toss your coin then, whoever was going to win. So I went 11-9, 12-9, and I says, right, I've got him now.
Yeah.
And I went 12-11, and I think Lady Luck was smiling on me tonight, because at the final frame I had some outrageous bits of luck, but now thank God I got them.
And to be honest, were the little doubts creeping through your mind towards the end that you think, my goodness, you know, can he possibly do it?
Yeah, but from 12-9, I didn't really feel like... From 12-10, sorry, I didn't really feel that great inside. Even if Steve gave me a chance, deep down I was like, I don't think I'm going to do anything here. Just the way I was feeling. Whereas the last match against Dave Harold, I got a chance in the last frame and I really fancied clearing the table. But tonight, I managed to do a little 40, I think, and a few of the reds were safe. But then Steve potted a great long red, and he was in about it to maybe clear up, but thank God he never.
He said he grinds people into the dust still. Did you feel you were being ground into it?
Exactly. I was ground out.
Well, you've done it, you've come through, you've got Anthony Hamilton. I don't care who you play, you probably think, I've just beaten Steve Davis, that's enough. Yeah. John Higgins then, through tonight in an epic with Steve Davis.